Sanchez from TNT Martial Arts and Fitness in San Dimas, California. And I'm here with a friend and training partner.
Hey guys, it's Eric Perez from VS Taekwondo in Montebello. And today we're here with you with the Youth Taekwondo Podcast. In today's video, we're going to talk about our five favorite Taekwondo fighters.
Yeah, this is in no particular order, just our top five favorite Taekwondo fighters. We obviously have more than five. We have a lot more than five.
Yeah, we have a lot more, but we just narrowed it down to five for the sake of the video and for now.
Yeah, maybe later we could go a top 10.
Yeah, so let's get started. Number one, we have Levin Tungkat. Yeah,
Levin Tungkat, this guy's very explosive, very athletic. He throws every kick in the book and lands most of them.
Yeah, he could chain a bunch of different kicks together and, you know, throw a bunch of cool combinations. It's really nice to watch.
Yeah, high energy for sure, entertaining to watch, and he lives in the old school. Really dope fighter.
Yeah, I actually took a seminar from him. I went to a seminar like a few years back, I think. You know, he does a lot of explosive drills and power drills and reaction drills, you know, because that's really what his style is all about.
Yeah, most of the athletes on our list are small guys in the weight division.
Yeah, I think that could benefit you. Could really relate to that. I can too, but...
Yeah. But anyways, next up on our list is Servet Tazkul. A Turkish Taekwondo champion, Olympic champion. I'd say 2012 was his best year. He went on a rampage in 2012. He won gold in Manchester, gold in German Open in Hamburg, and of course he won gold in the Olympics in 2012.
Yeah, I don't really know too much about him, but you know, I like watching him. I like his speedy style, just like Levin Tungkat. You know, they fight really similar. Well, up next we got Ruslan Poisev. Russian fighter, competed in the 2015 World Taekwondo Championships.
Yeah, this is a guy. This guy got a lot of mind game from. He went into the 2015 World Championships. He was looked at as a smaller guy, and he took bronze, but in my eyes, he took gold.
Yeah, you know, he really knows how to use the punch to his advantage. You know, he's fought some tough opponents like Lucas Guzman and Farzan.
Yeah. I'd love to get some training sessions with this guy. I feel like he could really help me out a lot with my game and style.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, moving on to number four, we have Aaron Cook. He's won multiple Opens, a bunch of world championships. You know, he competes a lot. You know, what's funny about him is he's a really big guy. You know, he fights heavyweights and he moves really fast. You know, you don't see a lot of heavyweights throwing spinning kicks and all sorts of things.
Yeah.
So yeah, if anyone who knows Taekwondo, even a little bit, knows about him for sure.
Yeah. Okay, guys. Number five, we have Ahmad Abu-Ghosh.
Ahmad Abu-Ghosh, you know, he competes. You know, he's adapted to the newer style, so that's why I like watching him. You know, he fights in minus 68 kilogram division. He won the 2016 Olympic gold medal. You know, he fights really technical, but you know, he knows how to throw all sorts of kicks, you know, but he finds the right timing. Yeah, so it's really nice. It's really cool. You guys should check him out, definitely.
Yeah. Well, all right, guys, that's all for our list. And we've met some of these fighters before, so we'll post a picture so y'all can see.
We'll try to link the videos in the description if YouTube lets us. But yeah, we hope you guys learned from these fighters as we did, and we'll see you guys in the next video. See ya. Thank you guys for tuning into our podcast. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe.
Let us know what topics you guys want to hear about in Taekwondo.
Yeah, and any questions, feel free to message us. Our social media will be in the description. And yeah.